بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
Inspired 2015.
If you ask a Muslim now, male or female, brother, sister, what is your dream? What's your aspiration? What are you working towards? The majority of people, their dreams are worldly based. They're dunya based now. Say, I wish I can become rich. I wish I can have a house on the beach. I wish I can own this car. I wish I can marry this person. I wish I can be a celebrity like this person, like this actor or this actress. This is what common amongst us in every Muslim society, in everywhere we've went, subhanAllah. We've seen this tendency that our youth, they are aspiring dunya. And when it comes to akhirah, when it comes to the hereafter, when it comes to the pleasure of Allah, our aspirations are minimal. We find people saying, Allah, all I want is just to slip into Jannah. I just want to enter Jannah, one foot, I'm happy. SubhanAllah, in dunya, in worldly things, you are not content of being of the lower rank. You aren't content with having something simple, you know, in dunya and live a simple life. You wanted the best status. You wanted the best car. You wanted the best house. Now comes the hereafter, the true life, your real life. And now you want to slip into Jannah because our dreams are wrong. Our dreams are not faith-based. They're not iman-based. We have lost that connection. We have lost the battle within. Khalas, we think Islam will never stand up, you know. Nowadays we hear people, Muslims love talking about the signs of the hour. Ever felt this in your community, you know? People love hearing about the Dajjal. They love hearing about the Mahdi. Why? You know, the state of Islam will, you know, this current state will end. We just want it to end. Anyhow, anywhere, you know? La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. You know, we've reached such a weak state. We talk about the Mahdi now as if khalas, from now until the Mahdi appears, there is no hope, my brother, my sister. Let's just continue making more dunya. Let's just continue being engaged in this world and its desires and lust and shahawat. And don't worry about the hereafter. We'll wait for the Mahdi, inshallah. Don't worry about deen. We'll wait for the Mahdi, inshallah. Well, guess what? This was not the way of our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This wasn't the way of our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This wasn't the way of his companions. Islam does not know negativity. Islam does not know giving up. إِنَّهُ لَا يَيْأَسُ مِنْ رَوْحِ اللَّهِ إِلَّا الْقَوْمُ الْكَافِرُونَ Only those who do not have iman, they lose hope in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's victory. We have to dream on. We have to actually aspire. We have to be ambitious. We have to dream. We have to think properly. Where do I want my rank to be with Allah? Am I content with something small? This shouldn't be the case. Look at the Sahaba radiallahu anhum and how they viewed things. A famous story. A man radiallahu anhu, his name, maybe many of you don't know him. You know, his name is Rabiah Ibn Kaab al-Aslami radiallahu anhu. This young companion was from Ahlul Suffa. Those of you who know, Ahlul Suffa were those poor people in Medina. They were homeless. No home, no wife, sometimes even no clothes. They did not have enough clothes to cover their own awra, their own private parts. Sometimes they had to pray half naked or part of his awra showing. No food, nothing. One of them was Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu, very famous. But this man, Rabi' ibn Ka'b, was from Ahlul Suffa. وَكَانَ يَخْدِمُ النَّبِيَّ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ He was one of the servants of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. So one day, he is preparing the wudu for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, preparing water for his ablution. So he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam looks at him, he is pleased with him. He is pleased with his service. So he says to him, Ya Rabi'a, O Rabi'a, salni, ask anything of me. Now I want you please to leave this story. You know, get involved in the story. Imagine yourself in Rabi'a's shoes. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the king of Medina. I have no home, I have no job, I have no wife, I have no clothes. And the king of Medina now, the leader of Medina is asking me, ask something of me. I'll do whatever you ask of me. What would you do? What would you ask for? Wouldn't you ask for a house? If the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says to the Ansar, people of Medina, if he says to them, give him a house, wallahi, instantly they will give him a house. Marry him off, find him a wife. Instant, the orders of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, done and thus finished. Whatever he says happens. Give him a house. Give him a wife. I can ask anything now. Or give me clothes, Ya Rasulullah. Give me a abaya. Give me something to wear to cover my awrah. Rabi'a radiallahu anhu. Look at the focus. Look at the fikr. Look at the direction. Rabi'a radiallahu anhu says, Ya Rasulullah, as'aluka murafaqataka fil jannah. O Prophet of Allah, I want to be with you in Jannah. Not any Jannah, Ya Rasulullah. Not any Jannah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He didn't ask him for any Jannah. He wants to be in the Prophet's rank. I want to be with you in Jannah, Ya Rasulullah. In your rank in Jannah. What an aim. What an ambition from someone who has nothing in this world. قَالَ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ أَسْأَلُكَ مُرَافَقَتَكَ فِي الْجَنَّةِ. So it's like he, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Wallahi, sometimes I feel when I read this hadith that the Prophet himself, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he was asking him, when he was requesting him to put forward something, he actually expected him to ask something of dunya, some food, clothes, something. So he, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, says, أَوَ غَيْرَ ذَلِكَ أَوَ هَابَ أَوَ good, mashallah. Anything else? Now say you want a wife. Now say you want a house. Find me a job, Ya Rasulullah. Give me some money, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Qala Ya Rasulullah, huwa dhak. That's all I want. All I want is to be with you in Jannah. But the path is not easy. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam knows that. If you want to be with me in Jannah, qala fa'inni ala nafsika bikathrati sujood. If you want to be with me in Jannah, Ya Rabi'a, then please assist me by doing a lot of prostrations, a lot of sujood. You need Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on your side. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has to allow you that rank. You have to work hard for it. But look at the direction, look at the focus, and compare the fikr of Rabi'a radiallahu anhu to our dreams and our ambitions. Where do we want to be? What do we want to do? No ambition in our ummah now to be close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to get the highest ranks. Even though, wallahi, it's very easy in our time compared to previous times. There's no competition. Everyone's chasing dunya anyway. Everyone's after dunya anyway. Anyone who does something small for deen, straight away he becomes Allah. Straight away Allah uses him. Because there's not much people taking that path in the first place. But subhanAllah, still the majority of our ummah are directing their fikr and attention and effort and focus and sacrifice and investing it in this world. And the fikr and the concern and the worry for the hereafter is minimal. You see all this corruption around you. You see all this fasad around you. All this haram, orders of Allah are being disobeyed left, right and center. No salah, no deen, falling in sin, falling in major sin, abundant in every community. What do you feel in your heart? How can we go and sleep properly? You know, we miss Fajr. Sometimes if you sleep, you don't put your alarm on, you will sleep such a good night's sleep. You will miss Fajr next day. That's how much there's no concern in your heart. That's how void your heart is of concern. If you have court tomorrow morning, if you have an exam in your university tomorrow morning, you find yourself, you know, you can't sleep at night, or you keep waking every hour. Because you're hyped up, there's anxiety, you're anxious. But when it comes to the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, no one is really worried. This has to change.